Every Thursday, we invite you to answer, ask the questions. You're the answer particular.
Okay.
Right? Okay, back to Kalani Brady from the John A. Byrd School of Medicine here with some answers to your questions. This is a very interesting question. What is H. pylori, and how do we get it? What are the symptoms, and is it curable?
H. pylori, Ron, is a bacteria in the gut. We're not sure exactly how we get it. Some people who get it and have the antibiotics to cure it, and yes, it is curable, can get it again later, years later. So we're not exactly sure how it transmits. It usually causes no symptoms, but occasionally it can cause dyspepsia, that heartburn, that abdominal epigastric pain that causes us discomfort, and it can be treated. The treatment is a serious treatment. It's not just a couple of pills once. So that's what H. pylori is.
Wow, never heard of it. Okay, what can I do for an ingrown fingernail?
Go to the doc. This is not something that you want to handle at home.
Really?
The doc has special tools, and they can remove that ingrown nail.
Yeah, don't mess with that. Okay, this caller says, I have onycholysis.
Yep.
Okay, is it curable, and can it be reversed?
Onycholysis is actually the lifting of the nail off the nail bed. It can be caused from certain medications. However, probably more commonly in the world, it's because of very strong cleaners, industrial cleaners. And the treatment, of course, is to remove yourself from those strong industrial cleaners by wearing gloves so that you don't get the cleaner down in the glove to damage the nail.
Wow. Is a fatty liver curable, and how do I cure it?
Fatty liver is curable just like the rest of our fat. If you go on a low-fat diet for long enough, the fatty liver will resolve.
Okay. Caller asks, what causes restless legs?
Restless leg syndrome, Ron, is a disease, and it's caused by neurotransmitters in the brain. There are medications that can treat restless leg syndrome. If you don't treat it, it can result in sleeplessness for night after night after night. It's a very serious disease in terms of sleep disorder.
So we're not talking about when we do the, you know, sit at dinner and move our leg like that. That's
no.
Not, that's different.
That's not restless leg syndrome.
Okay.
It happens at night. It feels like you have to move it. Oh. It's relieved by moving it. But then, of course, if you're moving your legs, you can't go
to
sleep.
You're up. Wow, it must be very frustrating. I found that I have arthritis in my right knee. What can I do to help all the pain?
Well, there are many different kinds of arthritis, Ron, so it depends on the type. But in general, non-steroidal anti-inflammatories like ibuprofen or naproxen, Advil or Aleve over the counter, very safe, with food, can help the pain in the right knee. Also, resting the right knee can help. Physical therapy may also help. And asking the doctor, based on the type of arthritis, what specific treatments there are may help as well.
Icing?
Icing can work, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Dr. Brady, thank you very much. We have so many questions.